In this video, I will show you how to send data from Excel to Google Sheets with just one click, no coding required. So without further ado, let us dive in. So here on the left, I've got my normal Excel file saved on my desktop. And over here on the right, I've got my Google Sheets. Now to transfer all the data, all I need to do is to select the range I want to export, and then I'm going to click this button here. Next, I will just confirm my range, and now the data is being sent directly to Google Sheets. Once that is done, you will get a message box, and as you can see, the data is now here in Google Sheets. Now what's nice about this is that it's super flexible. So if you want to update any cells, add more columns or rows, that is totally fine. When you're done, just select your range again, click the button again, and just like that, the data in Google Sheets gets updated. Also, your data doesn't have to be in a perfect table. Just like here in the weekly sales sheet, the cells are a bit scattered. But just like before, you can just simply select your range, click the button, confirm the range, and then the data shows up in Google Sheets. Now, something to keep in mind is that you can only transfer cell values. So you cannot transfer formulas, shapes, formatting, or any stuff like that. However, on the other hand, none of your existing formats in Google Sheets will be overwritten. So if you've colored your cells or changed your column width, that's gonna stay as it is. And to show you that, I will go ahead and clear my data here. Then, back in Excel, I will export it again. Alright, so now that you have seen how it works, let me show you how to set it up yourself. So first off, you want to create a new Google Sheet. I'm gonna name mine Excel Sync Test, but the name doesn't really matter. Also, just so you know, you could technically create any sheets inside this workbook dynamically. And I will give you a little hint later in the video on how that works. But for now, I will just keep things simple and I will create two sheets here. And they will have the exact names as in Excel. So one is called sales data and the other one is called weekly sales. Alright, so with that in place, we can now set up the actual automation. For this, I will be using a no-code tool called Public Connect. Now, there are a bunch of no-code automation tools out there like Zapier, N8N, Make.com and so on. I just happen to use Public Connect because they offer a lifetime deal, so that means you only pay once and you can use the tool forever. But just to be clear though, this video isn't sponsored by Public, so feel free to use any other tool you like, that is totally fine. However, if you also want to give Public Connect a try, you can sign up for the free version. Or if you also want to grab the lifetime deal, just click the banner here at the top and then scroll down a bit. Personally, I'm using the ultimate plan since I have set up a ton of automation flows. But like I said, if you're just testing things out, the free version should be totally fine. Alright, so once you're logged in, you will see this kind of interface. Here, just click on Create Workflow. Next, I will choose the new workflow builder and give it a name, something like Sync Excel Data. After clicking OK, you can now start building your automation pipeline. Now, every automation workflow starts with a trigger event. And in our case, the trigger is gonna be a webhook. So I will search for a webhook here. Once you find it, just click on it. Then for the app event, we will select Catch Webhook. Alright, once that is connected, you want to turn off the simple response and then copy the webhook URL to your clipboard. As soon as you do that, Public is now listening and waiting for any data to be sent to that URL. And to send the data, we will use my Excel add-in called Excel Prompt. Once you've got Excel Prompt installed, you will see this ribbon here. Here you will want to click on Settings. Now, first, let me reset my current settings back to default, just so that we are all starting from the same place. Next, go to the Webhook tab. Here, enable the Webhook integration, and then paste in the Webhook URL you just copied from Public Connect. Alright, and with that set up, go back to the General tab. This is where you can specify the output format of your Excel data. By default, it's in an array format, which is exactly what we need. But, just so you know, you can change the format using the drop-down box right here. And below that, you will see a preview of what your output data will look like. But, like I said, I will stick with the array format. Next, I also want to send some metadata along with the Excel data, like the range address and the worksheet name. Alright, so with that done, let's save and close the setting and test it out. And as you saw earlier in the video, it is actually super easy. So, you just select your range, click the Send to Webhook button, and then confirm the range by clicking on OK. As soon as you do that, you should now see in Public Connect that the data has been received. So if we check out the response, you will see the metadata, like the worksheet name and the range, along with the actual Excel data. Alright, so now that we've got the data, we can now go ahead and use Public to connect it with Google Sheets. But before we do that, we need to do a quick cleanup step, because right now the data starts and ends with double square brackets, and we need to remove those to make it work with Google Sheets. Now, technically, you could use a small bit of Python or JavaScript code in Public to fix that, but those modules aren't available if you're using the free version. So that is why let me also show you another method that also works with the free plan. So first, add another step. Here, search for text and then select the text formatter app. For the event, pick replace text. Once that is connected, you will select the input text. In our case, that's the Excel data we got from the webhook. Now within that data, we want to find the double opening square brackets and replace them with single ones. Now when you save and send a test request, you will see that the data now starts with just one square bracket, and that is exactly what we need. Alright, and now we also need to do the same thing for the closing brackets. So, in the next step, we will add the text formatter again and choose replace text for the event. This time though, we are not grabbing the data from the webhook. Instead, we are going to use the output from the previous cleanup step. And just like before, we will look for the double closing brackets and replace them with a single one. Then hit save and send a test request. Okay, now that both cleanup steps are done, we are now ready to send the data to Google Sheets. So, for the next action step, search for Google Sheets. Now remember earlier, I mentioned that you could technically create a new sheet on the fly. For that, you would select create a sheet. But you probably also want to check first if that sheet already exists. Now for our simple workflow though, we will just assume the sheets are already there and we only need to insert the data. So that is why here I will pick update range values. Once you click on connect, you will need to choose your connection. Now in my case, I have already connected Public Connect with Google Sheets. But if you are doing this for the first time, you will need to add a new connection. For that, just sign in with your Google account and grant Public Connect the required permission. And of course, just make sure you use the same Google account that you also use to create the sheets. Okay, once that is done, you can now select your spreadsheet. For me, that's the one I called Excel Sync Test. Next, you will want to choose the sheet name. And to make things more dynamic here, you can turn on this toggle and map the sheet name from the webhook response because, as you remember, we also sent the sheet name as part of the metadata. Now, if you wanted to make it even more flexible, you could have also selected to send the workbook name from Excel prompt. And if you created a matching workbook in Google Sheets, you could map that too. But, like I said, I will keep it simple here. So, for the next step, I will pick the range. Now, since we also sent that range from Excel prompt, I can just click here and grab it from the webhook event. Alright, and last but not least, we also need to specify the values we want to send. Now, since we already did the cleanup steps earlier, we will pick the data from the last text formatter step. Alright, and that is basically all there is to it. Now, to test it out, I'm gonna click on save and send test request. Okay, and if I scroll down a bit, this looks good here because we didn't get any errors. That means if I go back to Google Sheets and select the sales data, we should now see our data from Excel here. Alright, cool, and here it is. So now that we know it's working, there's one optional step you could add. So you can set a message that gets returned to Excel after the automation is done. And to do that, you can add the data forwarder step at the end of your workflow. For the event, select return custom response to the source. Once connected, you can type in your response in a JSON format. For example, you could set the key like result, and the value could say something like transmitted to Google Sheets. Alright, so with that in place, let's test it one more time. So I'm gonna place my Google Sheets and Excel side by side. Now I will go to my weekly sales sheet and select the range I wanna export. Once I click the send to webhook button and confirm the range, we will get the success message. And as you can see, it also includes the custom text from Public. But of course, more importantly, we can see that our Excel data is now showing up in Google Sheets. Now, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, if you also wanna start using Excel prompt, just check out the first link in the description box below. Once you purchase it, you will get a welcome email, and that welcome email also includes a link to the Getting Started video, which walks you through the installation process, and the installation itself takes only about 2 minutes. And finally, just so you know, you can do so much more with Excel prompt. Sending data to Google Sheets is actually just one example. If you're looking for inspiration on what's possible, check out this video right here. In that one, I will show you how to send emails from Excel, post Slack messages, create dynamic websites using Excel data, and even analyze your data with the help of AI. So feel free to check out that video. And as always, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.